in Allah from the evil of our souls and our sinful deeds. Whoever Allah guides, and then can mislead, and whoever Allah misleads, and then can guide. Allah Ta'ala, the Almighty, revealed to us a guidance, direction, and spirit. That is the book of Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, which is full of guidance, full of direction. And if we reflect upon this book, we will find that guidance, we will find that direction that we need in our lives. Allah Ta'ala in the Quran said, إن هذا القرآن يهدي للتي هي أقوم. Indeed, this book guides towards that which is the straightest. Not the straight path, but the straightest path. The most just and the most right path. إن هذا القرآن يهدي للتي هي أقوم ويبشر المؤمنين الذين يعملون الصالحات أن لهم أجرا كبيرا. And it gives glad tidings to those believing men and women that they will have a great reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So in every confusion, in every dilemma, in every problem, in every challenge that you face in your life, go back to this book. It'll give you direction, to give you guidance. Today I'm asked to talk about how to make your husband happy. How to make your husband happy. And I can say it is impossible. It is impossible if you don't refer to the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and understand His guidance in this regard. And I'm happy, so I'm very happy today. This is what talk about Qiran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty, when He spoke about the marriage. The marriage contract. He said that this contract is a sacred contract. Heavy contract. And if you reflect upon the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you won't find any contract that being named by being sacred contract except the contract of marriage and the contract of prophethood. Allah Ta'ala in the Quran said, وَإِذْ أَخَذْنَا مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ مِيثَاقَهُمْ. And we took the covenant from all the prophets. Allah Ta'ala took a covenant from each prophet that He will deliver my message. He will call people to me and He will never take anything in return. He will convey to people that I'm the only God worthy of worship. This is the covenant of Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala to every prophet. وَإِذْ أَخَذْنَا مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ مِيثَاقَهُمْ وَإِذْ أَخَذْنَا مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ مِيثَاقَهُمْ ومنك ومن نوح وإبراهيم وموسى وعيسى وأخذنا منهم ميثاقا غليظا. And we took that covenant from you, O Muhammad, and from Isa, and Musa, and Ibrahim, and Isa, and we took from them a heavy and sacred contract. ميثاقا غليظا. And when he spoke about marriage, he says subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَكَيْفَ تَأْخُذُونَهُ وَقَدْ أَفْضَى بَعْضُكُمْ إِلَى بَعْضٍ وَأَخَذْنَ مِنْكُمْ مِيثَاقًا غَلِيظًا. How would you think of asking the dowry back after you live together and they have taken from you a sacred contract, heavy contract, ميثاقاً غليظاً. Once we realize that once we enter to this relationship, the contract of marriage, that this contract is very sacred in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, once we understand that there is rights upon us, and rights for us, and everyone abide by that, we can create a happy family.
we can create a strong family. You know, the lowest rate of divorce in the Muslim world is in Malaysia. The rate there is almost 7%. And the reason why, because in Malaysia, you cannot get married until you get a marriage license. In that license, you cannot obtain it until you go through a course in marriage. How we can live with another person? What is the right of the husband? What is the right of the wife? And that's why the divorce rate in Malaysia was reduced from 32% to 7%. Because people, they are aware of what they are entering into. It is very important that we refer to the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when it comes in how we can make each other happy and how we can create a happy family. Let me ask you first, because I don't know how many of you are married here. Okay, those who are married, please raise your hand. MashaAllah. Those who are not married, raise two hands. Those who have two wives, raise three hands. None, alhamdulillah, mashaAllah. 16. If you reflect upon the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you will find that the merit is based on two very important pillars. Two important pillars. The first pillar is, I'll begin with the rights of women, because afterwards I'll talk about them. The first right upon men is to treat their wives well. This is the first pillar in marriage. To treat them well. To live with them in gentleness, in kindness. To be kind towards your wife. To be gentle with your wife. And this is not a favor from you. It is an obligation upon you. Allah Ta'ala in the Quran said, وَعَاشِرُوهُنَّ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ. And live with them in kindness. Deal with them with gentleness. Be kind with them, because Allah Ta'ala, the one who created you and them, He knows that if you deal with them in gentleness and kindness, that will have an impact on you. That will return back to you. They will give you a happy life. They won't give you a hard life. And if I ask you now, those who are married, those who raise their hands, which period of your life or of your marriage was the best period? You would say, before marriage, or the first month of marriage, or the first few months of marriage. And you call it honeymoon. MashaAllah. You know why? Because at that time, we used to care about each other. We used to treat each other well. Used to be nice towards each other. Used to show the best of your manners towards each other. The husband used to care about his wife or his proposed wife. Used to text her, call her, care about her. MashaAllah Ta'ala. And some people, they carry on. And that MashaAllah Ta'ala, that relationship will extend for years. And some, their happy life will be short. Why? Because we change. We neglect Allah's obligations upon us. Allah Ta'ala said, وَعَاشِرُوهُنَّ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ. Treat them well. Treat them well. They said that there's a person who got married. And in the first day of his marriage, he took his wife to a hotel. And on the stairs, she fell down. He was, mashallah, full of care about her and full, mashallah, ta'ala, of gentleness. Are you okay? Shall I help you? Shall I call the ambulance? What shall I do for you? He showed her the best of ما شاء الله تعالى gentleness and kindness. But after 1 year of marriage, the same man, the same woman, went to the same hotel, and at the same place she fell down. What did he say? What? Are you blind? Every time you fall down, what's wrong with you? He changed. And she will change. She will change. Subhanallah ta'ala. Some people, they understand that to gain the heart of your wife is to treat her well. And once you treat her well, that will return back to you. The second pillar of having a happy life and blessed life in the light of the Quran and the Sunnah is for women to listen to your husband. I know it's difficult. I know it's hard. But it's an act of worship. It is an act of worship. And you listen to him in that which is only allowed in Islam. And that which is not prohibited in Islam. That which will not violate the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He listened to him. And that's why the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِذَا صَلَّتِ الْمَرْأَ خَمْسَهَا وَصَامَتْ شَهْرَهَا وَأَطَاعَتْ زَوْجَهَا وَحَفِظَتْ فَرْجَهَا. If the woman prayed her 5 prayers and she offered her zakah or fasted her month and she obeyed her husband, she would enter Jannah with the greatest of ease. Because we have a ship and we need to have a leader. We cannot have 2 leaders. One person should lead. And he can always give feedback, inshallah. Can always give a feedback, inshallah, to your husband, and he can. And husbands should not take advantage, should consult him. The Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to consult his wives about important things, even outside the marriage issue. But in Islam, for marriage to stay strong, Allah ta'ala gave the husband that right. And he gave you a right, which is to treat you well. He has to treat you well. Let me move to giving you quick advice, sisters. How to make your husband happy. First of all, be patient. Be patient. You will never be able to harvest the fruits of your marriage in the first year or in the first years. It might take time. Be patient and always remember that the most difficult period of your marriage is the first year. The first years of marriage is the most difficult period. Secondly, lower your expectation. Lower your expectation. One of our main problems is that we have high expectations. When we get married, we think that this man will bring for me everything. This man is the man that will bring whatever I ask. And Allah Ta'ala, the Quran said, خُذِ الْعَفْوَ وَأْمُرْ بِالْعُرْفِ وَأَعْرِضْ عَنِ الْجَاهِلِينَ. What does it mean, خُذِ الْعَفْوَ? It means, do not burden people. Lower your expectation. Take that which comes without any effort, that which comes without burdening people. Take so lower expectation. Secondly, sister, avoid involving any person in your marriage. Try to resolve any issue between you and your husband together. Involving any person in your problems, making the family 2 sides, will create more problems. You can consult people, consult your husband, your parents, or your friends, or any imam or sheikh, but avoid to involve people in your own problems. Try to resolve them internally. That will create a healthy marriage, inshallah ta'ala. Thirdly, avoid comparing your life with other people's lives. try to live with the capacity of your husband, his affordability. Do not look at those who are above you. And if you keep comparing yourself with those who are above you, you will live a miserable life. And you will bring stress to your husband. He will feel that you are not, he will never be content. He will never be happy. Allah Ta'ala in the Quran said,
وَلَا تَمُدَّنَّ عَيْنَيْكَ إِلَى مَا مَتَّعْنَا بِهِ أَزْوَاجًا مِّنْهُمْ وَلَا تَمُدَّنَّ عَيْنَيْكَ إِلَى مَا مَتَّعْنَا بِهِ أَزْوَاجًا مِّنْهُمْ زَهْرَةَ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا لِنَفْتِنَهُمْ فِيهِ وَرِزْقُ رَبِّكَ خَيْرٌ وَأَبْقَى.
Do not look at the bounties and the good life that we give, have given to other people.
We have given them that as a test.
Then look at that. And this is a direction to the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What about us? In fact, you should look at those who are less than you, those who are under you, under your level. Look at them, then you become appreciated to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You'll be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look at those who are living less than you. Then you will appreciate whatever your husband is doing for you. And some sisters, wallahi, they are very good in this. They appreciate the husband. Whatever their husband did for them, they thank him for that. And they are happy with small things. Small things make them happy. And that will encourage the husband to bring more and to do more. But if whatever your spouse brings for you and you're not happy, you're not content, he will say, what's the point? What shall I do for her? He will give up. So if you are smart, always be appreciative. Be thankful. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you better. لَإِن شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. And likewise, people generally, if you are appreciative and thankful, they will think about how to make you more happy. Subhanallah. Some people, subhanAllah, if you want to know how they love their wives, because of the wife treatment and her nice approach and her patience and so on and so forth, they make dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala take their lives before their wives. Because they cannot afford losing their wives. They say in their dua, oh Allah, take my life first. I don't want to be bereaved with my wife. While some husbands, they make dua, oh Allah, take the soul of my wife in the years of judgment. Oh Allah, find for me a way out from the struggle. If you want to know the value of yourself in the sight of your husband, maybe you can check his mobile. I don't mean to check his mobile. Can check your name in his mobile. How he name you? Does he name you with honey? My honey? Or my love? Or my everlasting love? Or he called you boss? Dilemma. Disaster. Or maybe he give you a number. Number one. And that means he has another number. Subhanallah ta'ala. Some wives, they do their best to treat their husbands very good, very nice, and that will bring happiness, will bring tranquility in the house. So it begins from the husband, and then also you have a duty to treat him well as well. Treat him well. Let me move to another point now. When he arrives home, when he returns back from work, how do you receive him? Should you receive him with MashaAllah ta'ala, beautiful clothes, nice clothes, you put perfume, and you greet him Welcome. I miss you so much. How was your work? It's comforting. Ask about his challenges and how he spent the day. If you do that, he will feel happy to come early to home. But as soon as he returns back to home, if you are waiting there to question him, where have you been? Why you are late? Or you have a list of demands. He will choose to stay the night with his friends or spend the time with his friends. So as soon as he returns back to home, make sure that you welcome him and meet him with nice words, nice greetings. And give him time, attention. I know you have kids, you have kids, and you're busy with them. But once he returns back to home, give him time. Give him attention. Some women, subhanAllah, they are busy either with their children or with their mobile. The husband, sometimes he feels jealous of the mobile. Why? Because the wife is busy with that mobile, looking at the Facebook, looking at WhatsApp, looking at all of those social media. And I remember one man said to his wife, it's a joke, said, he saw her very engaged with her mobile. He said, I wish that I am that mobile. I wish that I am that mobile so it can give me some attention. What did he say? Then I wish that the woman said to her husband, sorry. I wish that a man busy with his mobile, his social media. And the woman said that, I wish that I had that mobile. I wish that I had that mobile. And the man said, I wish too. Why? So I can change every 3 years. Be busy with those devices and neglecting your wives, neglecting your husbands is wrong. As soon as the husband comes home, you have to give him time, attention, and look after his needs. Meeting him with a cheerful face, smile. Some women, subhanAllah, they have the time to be very nice and to be cheerful and to be smiling with everyone except her husband. And he will search for that somewhere else. If you don't do it, he will search for it somewhere else. So make sure that you do that and you practice this. Now we come to another point here, important point. Exchange a loving phrase with him. Loving text with him. Spend some time in doing that. When was the last time that you sent to your husband a message saying, without any reason, without any excuse, you said, I love you. I just love you because you are my husband. When was it? If anyone did that in the past week, raise your hand. Anyone? MashaAllah. 2 or 3. Make it a habit. Make it a habit. And you will be rewarded for this. The nice word I say to your wife is rewardable. And moreover, it is halal. It is halal. By Allah, it is halal to say to your wife, I love you. Say that. That will increase the bond between you. That will increase the love amongst you. I know you love her, and it's difficult for you to say that sometimes. But likewise, do that. Do that, and it's an advice for the women and the men as well. Sisters, another advice. Avoid being controlling. Avoid being controlling. Some women, subhanAllah, they feel that their happiness is when they control their husbands. With that, you will never achieve anything. You will achieve whatever you want, when you have trust on your husband, when you trust him, when you show him that you have a strong trust upon him, that will bring happiness in your life. But controlling your husband will bring nothing but misery, but difficult life. Sisters, you will achieve happiness. You will achieve rest and peace of mind once you know that pleasing your husband is an act of worship. When you please him, that is an act of worship. In fact, do you know that you are the main source of his happiness? Do you know that? What is the evidence? The Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Ad-dunya mata'," this life is full of enjoyment. And the best enjoyment of this life is, the best blessing of this life is, the righteous woman. Because she will be there for him when he's in need. She will look at Khadija radiallahu anha, how she was the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, helping him, supporting him, being there by his side when he was belied and denied, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So you can be the main source of happiness to your husband. This is in your hand. This happiness is in your hand. You can grant it to your husband, and that will return back to you. That will return back to you. I know they said that there is an imam who was given a talk about dhuhur, about dhuhur in Jannah. And he was talking about their beauty, their brightness, their faces, their eyes. And the people were praying, or the musallin were listening. One of them was focused, and everyone was paying attention. One of them was talking to himself, saying, "Alhamdulillah, I'm going to have this, inshallah, in Jannah, and I will get rid of my wife. Allahu Akbar." He was very happy and pleased because he's controlled at home. One of the musallin asked the imam, said the imam, "What about our wives? What about our wives in this dunya? MashaAllah, spoke about the stories in Jannah. What about our wives?" He said, "Your wife, who will enter Jannah, they will become the queens of those huris." The man shouted, "Oh Allah, oh my gosh, in this life and the hereafter as well? You are after me, behind me?" SubhanAllah. And another imam asked the people, "Is there anyone of you here that he's not controlled by his wife? Or he does not pee from his wife? If he pee from your wife, stand up." And everyone stood up. Apart from one person, said that. He said, "MashaAllah, you have a great person here." He asked him, "MashaAllah, you don't pee from her? Or does it control you?" He said, "No. He asked me and commanded me to sit down." Stop being controlling. That will take you to nowhere. Have trust on your husband. That will increase the love amongst you. That will enable you to live in harmony and to live in blessed life. Brothers and sisters, if we refer always on the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we will always find direction, guidance for us in how we can live together, in how we can live in a happy life. May Allah bless you all, and may Allah grant us all a happy life, righteous husband and righteous wife. Wa assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.